Hi, PhotoPiller! In this video, you'll learn how to plan a moon appearing from behind a mountain. Let's do a real case. We will plan a photo taken by the landscape photographer Marcos Molina during the year 2011. Have a look at this picture representing the scene. This is the mountain called Penyal, located in the beautiful island of Mallorca. We would like to capture the full moon appearing from behind the mountain. Marcos took the photo using a teleobjective to center all the attention on the giant moon. As we always do, let's place the observer's pin in the location from where we want to take the photo. After studying several possible locations, Marcos decided to take the photo from a spot near the village of Bunyola, a place with great views of the mountain. He gave us the latitude and longitude of the spot. Let's introduce them to position the observer's pin. Now, let's tap on the obstacles button to make appear the obstacles pin, this button over here. Then, let's place the obstacles pin on the mountain, where we want the moon to appear from behind it. The obstacles pin is tied to the moon's pin of the find option. This means that if we use the find option now, we'll have the moon's pin at the same location as the obstacles pin. In the information box of the obstacles pin, you find its altitude and its relative altitude and elevation. We explained in the obstacles video that the first value tells you the altitude above the sea level of the obstacles pin. The second value tells you the relative altitude between the obstacles pin and the observer's pin. In this example, this number is telling us that the obstacles pin is at a height of 423 meters above the place from where we want to take the photo. The third value is the relative elevation of the obstacles pin to the observer's pin, 5.5 degrees. Let's see it on a picture. This is the observer's pin, which is located at an altitude of 362 meters above the sea level. The obstacles pin is at the top of the mountain, at an altitude of 785 meters above the sea level. We know the distance between the two pins and its relative altitude, 423 meters. PhotoPills automatically calculates the relative elevation of the obstacles pin to the observer's pin, 5.5 degrees. Why is the relative elevation between pins important? Well, the relative elevation is the elevation of the moon you must introduce when using the find tool of the planner. It's the elevation that will give you a moon just appearing from behind the mountain, seen from the observer's pin location. When the moon is above this elevation, the moon will be visible. And when the moon is below this elevation, the moon will be hidden by the mountain. There is another way to do the search. As we saw in a previous video, we can use the apparent altitude concept. When doing the search, you must set an elevation of the moon that gives you an apparent altitude of the moon at the obstacles pin of 423 meters, which is the relative altitude between the top of the mountain and the spot from where we want to take the photo. Let's use the find option. Choose to look for a moon at azimuth and elevation. As you see, the moon's pin is already placed in the location of the mountain because it is tied to the obstacles pin. Tap on the moon's pin to see the relative elevation. Here, you have the same information you get with the obstacles pin. Notice that it is not necessary to use the obstacles pin before you start the search. You can move the moon's pin directly on this screen, but it's faster this way. Let's set the elevation of the moon. That must be equal to the relative elevation between pins, 5.5 degrees. Use the numeric option, and also set an error value of 1 degree. Now, tap on the search button to get the results. We are only interested in full moons, in golden hour or blue hour. Let's sort the table by phase to see the full moons first. Don't consider the moons with an elevation below 5.5 degrees because the mountain will hide them. This date is a good one. A full moon, in golden hour, and with an elevation of 5.6 degrees. Tap on it to see the planning. As you see, the current azimuth of the moon is aligned with the obstacles pin, which we placed on the mountain. The sun is at an elevation of 0 degrees. It's setting. And there we have a full moon. Finally, like Marcos did, just get out there, immerse yourself in the great outdoors, and enjoy capturing unique moments. Enjoy his photo, a legendary one. That's all, PhotoPiller. Thanks for watching.